Hello, welcome to Kraaft It Live. I'm your host, Heather, and this is Kraaft It Live, a live crafting show where fun is to be had, mistakes are bound to happen, and you just might learn something too. It is summertime here at the Craft Shack, and that means we are getting messy and just having fun. We don't care about projects. We don't care about completed pieces of art. Well, sometimes we do, but not this month. This month, it's all about getting messy and just having a good time. So this month, or today, this show is what I mean to say, I put it away. So I was going to show you what we're going to be playing with, the jelly plate. We're going to have the 8x10 jelly plate. It's been neglected. I've used the big one for so long that the 8x10 was like, hey, what about me? What am I? Chop liver? But no, you're not. You're a gelatin plate. So, all right, Sylvia, do you want to save the day here and make me stop talking? I'm joined by my fabulous friend Sylvia, who is going to welcome everybody while I switch the camera. Hi, Sylvia.
Hi. I'm just laughing because you introduced. You go, Heather here. Like she doesn't think like, that she's really
Heather.
My name. I don't know.
I forgot my name.
It cracked me right up. Okay. I want to say hi to Andrew and to Jazzy, BJ and Abe, Carol, Kim, Lynn's our cartoonist, and Jules. We're so glad you guys are joining us today. And today's message, I'll put that up while Heather gets her workspace going. Today's message, this summer, take a vacation with Jesus. Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. That's Matthew 11:28. That is such a great verse for any time, but for the summertime too. I love it.
Yeah. When I was typing it, I think I told you that it's funny when you know a verse by heart and then you go to type it and it's the version is not the same way you remembered it. Well, that was how that one was, because I remember it burdened and heavy laden.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it was hard for me to type it. Anyway, okay, look what I have. I have new stencils.
Woohoo!
Yeah, hey. So these are all from DecoArt. There's this
Those
really
are nice.
Yeah, it's a 12x12 large number stencil. I guess it's called numbers collage. I guess I could give you like the code number or something. Anyway, these are available from DecoArt. They're part of their Americana line, and they have letters too. And what I love about these is they're not the typical in line, in a row,
right?
You know, type things. They're a little wonky, and I love that. And they're different sizes, so that's going to be fun to play with.
I love that.
And then look at this one.
Look at that one. Oh,
I know. You and I are kind of suckers for these doily mandala types, I had to have it as soon as I saw it. So we're going to play with these.
Mm. Did you get that on your trip?
No, ma'am. I got them from the DecoArt website.
Oh, very pretty.
Yeah, pretty snazzy. So we can actually take these out of the package. I wanted you to see them in the package, though. Wasn't that fair?
And I don't know if anybody noticed, but Heather got a manicure yesterday, and I'm so glad she did, because those stubs were looking so bad.
The only one who cares is you, because of how bad they looked. But yeah, that's I will admit they were pretty bad.
Oh, man.
I will admit they did look pretty darn awful.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, they hurt, to be honest with you. I'm now at the point where I can't function without the nails.
Right. Everybody's liking the stencils. They think they're really great.
Good, good. Hopefully they like them when we use them on the plate. So I'd like to know who out there is jelly plating along with us. I know if Michael was here, he'd have his peanut butter out, but...
Yeah. Yeah, so who's playing along? Anybody going to play along today?
I had posted in our love-hate relationship with the jelly plate community. I don't even know what the heck the name of the community is, but I had posted in there that we were going to be working on it today, this week. So hopefully some folks were ready to play along. Okay, so these are good. These are good. So colors.
I have to say something. Andrew's saying, okay, just scan that and give me a line drawing. I think it was on the Mandela.
The Mandela,
yeah. Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, that'd be nice, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
All right, so I think I want to start off with some dark colors. As a matter of fact, that is exactly what we're going to start with. We're going to start with a black.
Ooh, okay.
I want to make a black page, maybe.
Interesting.
These paints have been neglected. I'm pulling out stuff that's been neglected. I'm getting ready to do an online yard sale, so I'm trying to decide, do I use this? Don't I use this? Do I need to buy more of this, or do I need to never have this at all? By the way, T-Dog is doing all the Instagram shots for you today. And if it all goes well, he'll be doing all Instagram from here on out.
Really? Well, he's been doing real good with the camera when you do the behind the scenes and, you know, taking us along on your journey and stuff.
I do have to tell you, he's quite witty. It's all him. So when he tries to take something based on what I'm saying to you guys, because he only hears one side of the conversation. Yeah. And he takes something totally out of context and uses it as one of the comments. I love it.
Isn't that kind of like what Linz does?
That just cracks me up. It's just like what Linz does, only not cartoon. It's in words. So
right,
yeah.
It's in words, yeah.
Too funny. Okay. That's good enough. See, I've already got, this is the reason why, because I knew my hands were going to get quite messy. All right. So let's take a poll. Do you know what I did with the paper?
I thought you had them.
Yeah, I got it.
Okay.
This is the first time I've jelly plated in this space, in this new space. So it's kind of hard to know where to put everything and not have it all over my computer.
Yeah.
All right. So I just wanted to make myself a black sheet of paper.
Oh, okay. That's interesting. I like that. Because I think something's going to go on top of it. I'm not sure, but I'm thinking.
You're thinking?
Uh-huh.
All right, so let's take this new mandala stencil.
Very pretty.
Put that there. And we're going to go get that off there. Push that into those nooks and crannies real good.
And since you're working with black, I just have to draw attention to Linz's cartoon today of Jake and Elwood. I just thought that was so hysterical.
Oh, the Blues Brothers. Yeah, that was awesome for Sunglasses Day.
Awesome, yeah. Just awesome.
Ooh, look at how cool that is. That's pretty cool.
Yeah,
I'm going to get some more of this one pulled up here and here. So the goal here when you're doing this is to get the paint off of those areas. So you're left with it like this. You can
look
see
how pretty that is. Oh my gosh.
Well, we'll see.
Oh my gosh.
All right, so we're gonna let this dry.
Okay,
do you have any comments you wanna bring up?
Hey,
you're gonna have moments we're gonna need comments today.
Okay. Just so you know. Okay, guys, you have to tell me Instagram too, okay? Cassandra's not here. Do an Instagram of that. That's real pretty. I like that.
T-Dog, come take an Instagram of this one, will you?
Yeah.
Instagram request, please.
It's got lots of detail in it. It looks great. Yeah, there was one comment, but I think it's gone by now. I'll have to try and find it. Kim is saying that she, you know how she's been doing her room with the paper bags and stuff, you know, and she's talking about doing another room where she's going to use egg cartons. Now that should be interesting.
What?
Yeah.
Egg cartons? Like in the bumpy form?
Yeah, I guess so. I'm not really sure, but they're talking about it over there.
That's interesting. So if you're watching us on YouTube, maybe you're watching this live on YouTube and you're wondering what are you talking about? There's a link in the description of the video for you to be over on the Kraaft Shaak website. Now I've been asked many times, why do you do it that way? Why don't you just let us do live chat on YouTube? Have you guys ever been to a live chat on YouTube and experienced some negativity or any of those things? Well, we try to curb that by keeping the conversation here. Now it has worked for close to what's it been, 3 years of doing this now?
No, I think it's been longer than 3 years, honestly, Heather.
I think we started in September of 2014, so it's just about, it'll be 3 years this fall that we've been doing it here on the website.
Okay, on the website. Okay.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay.
And we've never had a problem with somebody abusing anyone else or, you know, any negative conversation going on. So I really do like that. I think that our participants, our guests deserve that kind of safety. So if you're watching on YouTube and you're wondering why, there's your answer.
Yeah.
All right, are you ready for this?
Yeah, that's going to be so pretty.
All right, so you saw that I dried the mandala.
Yeah.
Part, so, right? That was dry. Yeah. And then I put a thin layer of PBO Dyna. This one is...
Oh, that's a Dyna.
Yeah, it's an iridescent red blue is this one. And then we're going to take a print of that. And that makes
Stephanie,
me wish...
Yeah.
Oh, go ahead.
Well, Stephanie's here, and her hubby were just in Disneyland. Yeah.
They were at VidCon. I'm so jealous. I wanted to go.
Yeah, it looks like they had a great time. Oh, look at that.
So did you see that? That's just a couple of steps. So the first step, when you want to get a print like this, the first step is to put down something dark. I used black in this case, and then take a pull. The reason why is because you want to get as much of that excess paint off of there before you put your stencil down. You put your stencil down, and then taking another piece of paper, pull off all of the open spaces from that. Okay, get all that paint off from those open spaces. Pull off the stencil and let that dry. Then give yourself a nice coat of something delicious like Dyna PBO paints. Oh my.
Wow.
You want to get an Instagram shot of that, T-Dog?
Yeah, and the one that he took of it before you put the red is on, and wow, what an excellent shot. The detail is incredible. And I'm glad he took it at the angle that he did, because it really does show the detail instead of being straight on. So if you have Instagram on a mobile device, you can go to Kraaft Shaak and check it out. If you don't, you can always use your computer, and you can go to Instagram.com / Kraaft Shaak and see, you know, the pictures that are going up. Very pretty. Wow.
Yeah. Is it okay if you add the link to the Instagram in our chat here? And also, if you're watching on YouTube, there is an Instagram link down in the description to go straight to our feed. So big thanks to T-Dog for being here with the camera and taking pictures for us. Okay, so that looks really cool. Now, once this one dries, I think it would be cool to do the opposite on that, but we got to wait for that to dry. So I also wonder what it would be like to have this over the top. Why don't we see? Because these are kind of transparent when you roll them out thin enough. So let's see what this is like. I really like working on the 8x10. I don't know why I have neglected it for so long.
Well, because traveling, it's easier to take the smaller ones. No, you take the big one, right? When you're traveling.
No, I don't. When we're doing the classes, it's the 5x5 one.
Oh.
But I'm meaning I've been using the big one almost religiously since I got it.
Yeah.
And I have really neglected my super awesome 8x10. I was actually thinking of selling this one.
It works great for what you're doing. You're using, you know, regular size paper.
Yeah. Well, I really want to make a journal. So that's a big reason why I'm putting the paint on the backside, so we get two-sided journal pages. Yeah, baby.
That looks yums.
And then where it hits that black, it really bounces back with the blue.
Yeah.
Wowzers. Oh, that's delicious. So these are the two different images that you get doing that.
Wow.
They're very different, even though they were made exactly the same stencil and colors. Very cool.
Very, very pretty.
All right. So I think we're going to go to this orange because I think that's going to work really well with this color scheme that I got going on here.
Mm-hmm. BJ just in capital letters went, "That's awesome, Heather."
I totally agree. I totally agree. Let's see. I also have something else I think I would like to add to this mixture of fun. Remember, this is summer play, so we got to take a minute and go get something. That's what we're doing. Iridescent medium. So this was talked about in one of the recent Kraaft It Lives. And yeah. I had actually purchased this at Hobby Lobby not too long ago, probably a year ago, to be honest with you. And this stuff is pretty cool. It doesn't do the exact same thing that these two-tone colors. You've got a two-tone. You've got a red, and then you've got a blue. So that's what's going on with these PBO paints. But you can get this pearlescent coloring going on in there. And if you mix two colors, it actually isn't that bad. So we're going to put this down. So it's a medium. So you can add paint colors to it. Let's do...
The thing about the Dyna is they have like two different colors in them.
Right.
Where iridescence just adds like a pearl shimmer to it or something.
Exactly.
So, yeah.
Yeah. Exactly. But you can kind of get the two-tone effect sort of with this. When you take like a green and a blue, for example, mm-hmm. and I'm putting on way too much product, just so you know, but it'll be worth it. It'll be totally worth it. These are just regular Kraaft paints, by the way. So they will mix with this iridescent medium just fine. I don't know why this color scheme just really pleases me, probably because it's so cool.
It's cool and it looks Caribbean, and who doesn't want to be in the Caribbean waters on the white sands running their toes through it, you know? I mean, it just conjures up all sorts of great visions.
I love watercolors. I think, yeah. You know, the color of water. I think that's what I love the most. But
oh, I remember when you did that jar. You carved that jar.
I did.
That's
funny.
An old paper.
That is. It is. All right. So when you have letters and numbers, make sure I'm doing this right, Sylvia. You put them down face down so that way they'll come up correctly.
Unless you don't want them that way. You want
that's true.
Then, yeah.
That's true. You could be funky like that.
Now, you're just using regular printer paper, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I was running into a problem there just before we went live trying to find my paper. Because, you know, everything's packed up for classes right now. With Kraaft Shaak on the go and... we come home to being here. It's been a little hectic.
Look how the brayer is kind of picking up the numbers.
Isn't that neat?
Mm-hmm. Oh, well, letters, I don't mean numbers. Ooh, look at that. Pretty, pretty.
I think we're going to do that again.
Yeah,
so
do
we
another.
Get a little bit of a ghosty. Because I had a lot of paint on there, so. And I just use more than one piece of paper here, so.
Oh, yeah, I like that one.
My photographer takes more Instagram pictures than I do, so you guys should be really grateful that T-Dog's in charge of Instagram now.
Okay, has he been posting them? Because I went and looked. I didn't
see anything. That was for Twitter, he just said. Listen to him. He's branching out.
Okay, because I'm not seeing them on Instagram. Okay, there he goes. Do you see what she is making? Well, join the show. Way to go, T-Dog. I love it.
Oh, that's so pretty. And it pulled up some of the red and the black.
Oh, look, you can see the iridescence in there. Very pretty.
See if I can get it to where it doesn't totally white out on you.
Very pretty. Anyway,
All right, I'm going to let that dry. That's going to be fun to add something to. Something maybe...
Got to be a contrast.
I know. Orange. I'm trying to think of what would be contrasty.
Orange.
All right, we'll do this. Orange. We'll do this orange. Actually, no, we won't. We'll do this orange. You love mixing orange and blue, and you know how that makes me feel.
Yeah, but it's cool, and you actually liked it when we've added as some colors. You got to liking it.
And you've seen me do that so many times since then, so you know how much I like it.
Well, Tide can't be all wrong. Orange and blue.
That's awesome.
Andrew's saying that Instagram and Twitter are merging. Oh, I think he's making a funny. Insta-twit. Okay, funny.
Okay.
Yeah, use the back side since you're gonna make a journal. Yeah. Now it's gonna get orange on it. Put a cover sheet on top of that before you.
You guys hear all that, right? It's not just me, right?
No, barking out the orders.
I love you, Sylvia. I don't know what I would do without you. My life would be incredibly boring without Sylvia.
Uh-huh.
I know this to be true. I'm not being a smart butt in any way. All right, here we go.
Oh, look at that. Oh, I like that.
And then because the orange is flat, it's got some shimmery pops on it.
Yeah.
If you can see that, I'm not sure you can, but.
Oh, I think that's yummy.
Ta-da.
Ta-da. See, Kim went, ooh. So.
All right. So since we had already put on orange, let's put on this.
Oh, and Carol said, TBO. Ooh, love the orange. So there you go.
There you go. See, it's a win.
It's a win-win. Don't be braring off on that. That's my page.
Oh, my goodness. Allow me to move it away, ma'am.
Okay. All righty.
Okay. Now.
Andrew said it looked like an Italian villa wall. It did, Andrew. A fresco type thing. It does. Cool.
Okay. Also, you want to have enough room on your table to be able to do this. All right. So this is just deli paper.
Ooh, like deli paper.
And I love using deli paper, even in the journal, because, like Sylvia taught me, it makes very interesting pages.
Yeah. Lynn's is, you know, she's making a little statement here. She says that she loves the process of jelly plating, but she never knows what to do with the prints afterward. Oh, Heather does a lot with them. I think the most fun thing to me is to make journals. I love to make journals out of them.
I like to make the journals, but I wouldn't say that's the most fun thing. I think for me, the most fun thing is the collaged art, but I'm just grateful we're all so different because I know you love making the journals, which it's cool. I like the journals, which that is what I want to do actually, is make a journal out of these prints.
Look at that. Wow.
I'm going to do that again. We need more of those.
Yeah.
But like these deli papers, for example, these are excellent collage papers because that will collage right over the top of other papers. And then you have these layers that are sort of see-through in spots, you know, the deli paper sort of disappears as you glue it on. So I really like doing those collaged pieces, you know, like the dragonfly or the...
Moosin and the... Yeah.
The buffalo.
The buffalo and...
Yep. As a matter of fact, I think we need to do another one of those soon because I really want to do some more collaged art.
Yeah, Lynn makes a point there too because she lives in London and it's pretty humid there. She says that her pages tend to be real sticky and then they always stick together. And I understand that. I get that. I don't have that problem out here though. Ha ha.
Ha ha.
That wasn't very nice. I'm sorry.
No, that really wasn't very nice of you, my friend. All right, so this is the black sheet that we made.
Oh, okay, here we go. You better get that lined up just perfect.
I'm trying. Could you tell?
Could you tell? Oh my gosh.
Could you tell?
Liz going raspberry back because.
There you go. There you go.
Yeah, it's the heat talking, Kim. I'm not kidding. And now the monsoon is moving in, you know, so we're starting to get some humidity. And it's nasty here. It's just really nasty. Look at that. Oh, my gosh.
Oh,
be still my heart.
I know. That's why I'm having to take a moment, if you don't mind.
Oh,
if you don't mind.
Is that yummy or what? T-Dog.
Yeah, he's nowhere to be found, so I'm doing it myself.
Oh my gosh.
Wowzers. That is take a moment right there.
And Andrew's saying, okay, that one gets framed and hung on the wall.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I hear you, Andrew. That is beautiful. Wow. Oh, I can't wait to see this Instagram. So while we're waiting for Heather to put the Instagram up, we have a little announcement to make about next Tuesday's show.
Oh, yeah. Thanks for reminding me. Next week, I don't know if you guys are aware of this or not, but here in the U.S., we be celebrating that thing called independence, freedom, and all that. It happens to be on a Tuesday this year. Nobody bothered to check with me first. But since it is on a Tuesday, we're going to go ahead and not have the show. So we're going to skip next week, but there will be one
the
week after.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah. We're going to be celebrating our independence, so.
Yeah, independently, not together.
Right.
All right, what do we do next? Okay, we haven't done the numbers.
How do you compete with that? Okay,
I don't know. Yeah. I don't know. Going back to this one for just a moment, I mean, can you see that goldy?
Yeah, I'm looking at it on Instagram, and it's got so much texture to it, too.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh, is that pretty.
Mm. All right, Heather. Okay, moving on. Let's see. I really liked that blue-green, and we need some more of that in for this journal to not be flat with just orange and red colors. So we're going to do this blue over the top. Let's do a little bit more.
Oh, Lynn's is getting deep now. She says, yeah, you couldn't handle the Brits Day. So.
She's very right about that.
Yeah. You were taxing our tea, sweetheart, and we didn't like it.
Yeah, that's why I drink coffee.
Yeah.
Actually, it has nothing to do with that. I'm just teasing.
No, I know. It has nothing to do with that. But we just have to say that. Ah, look what she's doing.
I just had to see if it would work, what it would look like if I did.
Well, it'll do something.
Yeah, something.
Something. See?
Well, it made marks.
Yeah.
It made some kind of marks. Those will be cool. So if this ends up being two-sided, then I can actually use that in my journal as well.
Yeah.
So we'll let that dry first before I flip it over. Okay, I need to know, because I'm not totally sure, but I think there's some goodness underneath that blue that I really wanted to bring up. So let's we're halfway through the show already. Are you kidding me? Time flies when you're jelly plating. That should be a thing.
Yeah, and
I think the tagline for the jelly plate.
The paper mounds stack up too.
Yeah, that they do. And don't layer them on top of each other because then they stick. Ask me how I know. Go ahead.
Yeah. Oh, I can't see. I can't see.
Sorry. Can you see it there when I turn
it? No.
You can't see that orangey?
It's
Oh, the
very
pattern is there. It's so cool.
okay. Instagram that then too, so we can see that.
My phone is ocupado. I don't know what in the world he's
I'm
doing.
trying to fix the thing that I just did.
Yeah, don't worry about it. Oh, well, we'll fix it later. We need to get pictures. He's trying so hard to do his job that let's take a photo of this. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, because it's
Right
kind of
there.
like
Share that one, buddy.
it's pixelated, you know? So.
What? Well, probably because he was trying to upload a video.
No, it's
That's
still
probably why it was
pixelated. Yeah.
pixelated. Yeah, I think because
Oh.
he's uploading a video.
Okay, I think I got noticed that it's there.
No, that's all
I don't
right.
know what I'm doing.
He did. I don't know if you guys could hear him, but he's like, "Sorry, I don't know what I'm doing." I think he's doing great.
No, he
Everybody
did
said,
really great because he did a video
"Applause for
that
you,
just
buddy.
uploaded. Yeah.
Applause
Oh.
for you, buddy. You're doing good."
Wow. Tell him he did excellent on that. He's got you on your screen and on your work desk. That's excellent.
I will tell him when we're done.
Okay. No, tell him now.
Oh, tell him now. Okay, she says to tell you that you did excellent on that one with capturing the work desk and the screen and everything. So you did good, buddy.
Oh, Michael's here. He says he's been listening on YouTube.
All
Oh,
right, so here we go. This is another PBO. Which one is this? This one. Oh, here, we're going to do this. Let's see if this works. Check this out. You can see this, right? Okay.
my gosh.
Yeah.
He put one up, taken through your screen, Heather, of you working.
It's Instagram inception is what's going on now.
Oh my gosh, that is so cute.
Good job, bud. You're doing really good. They can't stop commenting about it. You're doing a great job.
Oh, how cute.
All right, let's see. This one is the numbers one.
Oh. She says that the poppies are at the framers.
Who says she
Oh,
says?
Sheila.
Oh.
Poppies are at the framers. Video to of the reveal to follow. Oh my goodness, yes.
Oh, Sheila, that'll be so much fun.
Oh.
I don't know if you guys remember, but Sheila also bought the apple blossoms, and she did such a great testimonial about losing her sight and being able to see it again for the first time and all kinds of stuff. And so now she's going to share with us the poppies experience, which we hope no eyesight was lost for this one. We don't want any of that.
But one of the other nice things about that video that she did is she just showed how genuinely appreciative and helpful the Michaels people were to help her get it the way she wanted it. You know, it was so nice to see them working together like that.
All right, this I'm gonna go crazy on this one.
And Mark is here too. Glad you're here, Mark.
Woohoo!
Yeah. And Angela Heather is here too.
I am so glad to see you guys all joining us. Thank you so much. And anyone whose name says Heather in it is,
I know.
gets like extra points, so.
Yeah.
All right. I don't know which color I want to put on this. I'm trying to let it dry at the same time. Let's do this bright pink.
Oh, that'll be
Fuchsia.
pretty. Yeah.
Fuchsia, it says.
And that was a Dyna you used, right? That.
The iridescent blue black.
Okay, all right, yeah. And it's pink flat.
Yes,
Okay,
ma'am.
good. Okay.
Okay, that needs to dry somewhere, so. Where did I put my drying thing? I had a little fan that I was drying with, remember?
Yes.
So we'll get the big one out. Right, so sometimes, do you guys watch Barbara Gray? Oh, I love her videos. I don't know if you guys watch Barbara Gray, but her videos crack me up. Her humor. One time she's doing this technique where she had to let it dry, and the way that they edited the video, it looked like she was so bored to tears waiting for it to dry. Oh, it was hilarious. She's like spinning around on her chair and time ticks by and more time ticks by and then she's filing her nails and
clicking them on the desktop.
Yeah, pretty much. All right, we're dry. Houston, we're dry. Okay. Let's see if we have enough of this paint to do this. I'm down to the end of my crafty paints here. I really wanted a thin layer. That's not a thin layer, just so you know.
Ooh. Uh-oh.
Well, it was just the brayer off page, but come on. Don't get rid of my goodness. See what I mean? Ask me how I know that it will stick together. Go ahead.
Ooh, that's a lot of paint.
Agreed.
Too bad you don't have another jelly plate out where you could...
Oh, you know, that's a genius idea. I wish I would have thought of it. you're going to your room. Okay, let's see here.
God. Oh, we are looking at some old papers there, people.
Well, it's the stash of yeah, jelly plate on that, or yeah, use that as brayer paper.
I love it.
Okay, that should be good now.
That should be good, yeah.
I love the texture that comes out of my brayer. Yeah. That's just awesome. I'm not cleaning that off. You can't make me. I have one piece of unused paper.
Oh.
I better get more out. Oh, pool boy.
Paper boy.
Paper boy. So... I have to tell you guys, with all the Crash Shack on the Go stuff going on, this has been a very, very fun day for me because it's the first day, or the first afternoon anyway, that I haven't had to do a bunch of running around or crazy get ready for everything else stuff. I didn't like how that one was pulling up, so. All right, try it again from this way. Yeah, that's better, baby.
Oh, look at that. Wow. Wow. That's
see the iridescence in there?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
All right. We're going to Instagram that because he's left me. I think all the attention was a little much.
Okay, Michael's saying that this would be great in my brand new granddaughter's room. Yeah.
That is an excellent idea.
And congratulations on that too, Michael.
Yeah, I'm going to set this one aside. I've got an idea for that, Michael.
Oh, cool.
Okay, so there was one other thing, and congratulations big time. So there was one other thing that I really wanted to share with you guys before we say goodbye. And since we're...
Oh, we got lots of time.
On the last half of the show. Okay. Are you ever in the... Oh, good golly. Hold on just a minute. I put everything into that pink paint.
Oh, no.
We're good. We're good. I saved it. We're good. Okay. Woo.
Put that in the kitchen.
Yeah, it's a way. I promise it's a way. Okay, so have you ever been to the craft? Almost said to the craft shack. Have you ever been to the scrapbooking section at like Hobby Lobby or any of those stores?
Well, yeah. Isn't that why you go there? Yeah.
Okay. Well, when you go there, look for specialty 12x12 papers that look similar to this but aren't cut up. I'd already cut them, so I couldn't show you this, but.
What?
This is a specialty paper in the scrapbooking section. It's, you know how they have open stock?
So that is a see-through paper?
It's glitter paper. I'll bring it up in a second. It's glitter paper, and it's in this plastic container, this plastic sleeve. And then I just cut the strip so I could use it as a stencil.
Oh, for crying out loud.
So this was a whole 12x12 sheet of paper, this thing was. And it has these, basically these strips that you can use as stencils, and it's glittery on one side and then plain on the other. So once you get paint on this, it should hold up pretty well for a while.
Yeah.
So we're going to use one of those.
And then you'll get glitter too, so.
Maybe. And then this is another one.
Oh, wow, that's pretty.
Yeah, I'm trying to see which way it went. But I saw this and I thought, oh, that has to get cut into pieces.
Yes.
It's textured on one side.
Huh.
Isn't that nifty?
Yeah, that is.
So I'm going to take it out of the plastic holder that it came in. I found it easier to cut it that way and then it wouldn't get destroyed. But it's textured. I don't know if you'll be able to see that because it's really finely textured. But it's like that textured cardstock.
Yeah.
You know, that stuff, it's like that.
The core was a core. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. So it's like that. And then they laser cut it, this beautiful pattern out of it. I think that's going to be amazing to jelly plate with. So let's try it, shall we? This is where I always have trouble, the most trouble. I got fresh paper, by the way. Thank you, paper boy. What colors do I choose? That's where I always land in the worst positions because I'm afraid to ruin anything I've done. But this is, let's have fun time, right? So we can't do it wrong.
Liz, and we have saying that you're taunting her with all these neat buys because she can't get them in the UK. And the slave says, no matter how much she sulks, they're not moving to the US so she can go to the scrapbook, you know, scrapping section in the stores.
Listen, slave, don't let her move here. Fine. Because of scrapbooking stores. Fine. But let her move here so we can hang out with her.
Right, exactly.
And you can even come too. We don't mind you too much either. All right, let's see here. I just said the photographer. That's what I want.
Say what?
T-Dog just said, there you go. That's what I want.
Oh.
All right, let's do it on the back side of this one.
She says that slave says you can't handle her. She's a menace to society.
He's probably right.
Oh, God. See,
isn't that beautiful?
Card. Oh, that looks like a perfect card.
That's beautiful.
Oh, my goodness.
And then you want to carefully at this point take it off. But the more you use it, the more sturdy it will become. Okay?
Yeah. Wow.
I don't know what to do next. How about this bright magenta on the top of that?
Okay.
Okay. This is a really thinned out layer. Whoops. Oh, that's an annoying sound that my brayer's making.
Like on a chalkboard.
Pretty close to a chalkboard sound, isn't it? I think because of how transparent these layers are, I'm going to do it on deli paper.
Oh, there you go.
That'll be cool to go over the top of like a solid piece of cardstock or something as a card front. See, that's another thing, Linz, you can do with your jelly plates, just, you know, your poles anyway, not the plates. Cut it into a, you know, standard card size and you got a card front all ready to go. You could just stamp an image on the top or stamp a phrase on paper and then put that over the top of it. Oh my goodness. Wow. It pulled up some of the PBO from before.
Is that
you guys see all that?
Yeah. You're going to have to take an Instagram when you're all done of all these pulls because we've missed some of them. Wow. That's pretty.
No, you're fine, bud. Mm. He's over there taking pictures galore, so.
Lynn says card stick in the envelope because of the stickiness. Wow. Can you spray that with like any kind of fixative or something so it doesn't?
Baby powder or something?
Baby powder. Frost it. Frost it with baby powder. You said that same time Kim said baby powder. Maybe she's questioning your baby powder. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe. You didn't much like my idea. Okay, so here's where I want to add some accents to those things that I've made. So this is like a darker, almost purpley look. So I've got this area here.
Oh, I like that area, just plain like that.
That's fine. You can chill out.
Oh, now I feel like Linz.
And that's actually a good thing that you feel like Linz. Okay, so here we go. I'm going to just put this over the top of that.
Michael said Murphy's Oil.
Exactly. He knows.
Yes, he knows. If anybody would know, Michael would know. So.
Exactly. Let's do just a little bit on this one here. Photographers over here. Thank you. Oh, goodness. Okay, so now this one's going to go over this one here. You see what I did there? Can you see it?
Oh, you put a lattice work on top.
Yeah, that's using that sheet that was cut out. So for $1.99, you end up with like six stencils or something. Not too bad. Not too shabby.
Wow. Very, very pretty. Very well done, T-Dog. He's gotten some of these things uploaded.
Oh, wow. More compliments for you, buddy. You're doing a great job. All right. So I'm just going to pull this off to clean that off of there. And I missed some, which is not a bad thing. I just want to make sure it all comes off. And then I'm going to do the opposite. So let's roll out some of this magenta. The funny thing about gel plating, and we talked about this before, is that it seems to never end. So at any point in time, you might be ready to wrap things up. But when are you done? I mean, to clean it up, you put more on and
yeah.
You know, so some point I'm going to have to go because we need to go do some stuff for Craft Shaak on the go actually today. So, all right. I want you to sit down.
Okay.
This is dry. Not you.
I am sitting. Oh, that's a nice comment Lynn's made. She says, T-Dog, you need to get you taking more pics. You have a great eye. Yeah, he does. He's getting some really great shots, different shots, not your ordinary shot. Look at that. Wow.
And I wish he could hear what you're saying. Just like that, he grabbed the phone. He's ready to take a picture. I'm trying to put it so that he can get a good picture. Is that good there? No? Do you see his hand coming in there? That's his hand, bro. He's like, here, allow me, mother.
Yeah, I know what I need to have it do.
Yeah, I know what I need to do.
I know what I'm doing.
All right, I think I'm going to put down a creamy antique white.
Those are great stencils. They really are.
Isn't that cool? So I'm, killing time at Hobby Lobby because I've been to a few of those. And while I was... I know it's surprising to hear that, but while I was there, I perused the area that I have not been down in a long time, and that was the scrapbooking section because, honestly, paper is not something I've needed for...
Yeah.
At least half a billion years, maybe longer. So because that was not something I needed, I really never ever went down that aisle. And I just sort of decided I don't want to go over the top of that one with
no,
that solid color. I just
sort
of decided that it might be nice to go wander down there and see what's new, what's up. And when I saw those laser cut cardstock pieces, I was like, are you serious?
Wow. Lynn's was saying on that last one that it has a damask look, which is true. It really does. Yeah. I like that.
All right, let's see what this does.
Mark Burris says that he's the kind of guy that goes straight for the clearance bins. Oh my gosh, look at that one, people.
And it has some of that PBO paint still on there, so that's pretty cool. Yeah, I go to the clearance bins too, but I was trying not to spend money. And that seems to be the place where I spend the most money. Who knows why? All right, so see.
Resist spending money when you're in a store literally made for crafting.
Yeah, I don't know if you could hear that or not, but he's right. He said it's really hard to not spend money when you're in a store that's made for crafting.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, it's like that.
And designed to make you actually spend the money too. Don't forget that part.
It's like that thing I shared with you today.
Yes, exactly. You should actually
put that in here.
I don't know how you could do that. But
I don't know how I could do that either.
It was a great sign. You know how those signs are that we can all relate to. Okay, so this way we're doing it sort of the opposite. I put the paint on after I put the stencil on. Look at that.
Ah. Ooh, that looks pretty.
And then it'll have a white background from the paper. Very, very cool. This has been so much fun.
It is. It always is when you do jelly plating, because you get some really great things going there. Oh my gosh, look at that.
See? And there's even a ghost of the previous one in there, just lightly, ever so lightly.
Oh, how cool.
Okay.
Okay, okay, okay.
I'm not sure that I want to do anymore. I think I want to just leave it as is. Let's go back through. Let's do a recap.
Okay.
How about them apples?
Recap time. Oh.
Wow. Buried underneath here. All right. So this is the mandala. The photographer just told me, yeah, line them all up like that. I love the direction I'm getting. This is just awesome. All right. I'm cleaning up the paint so I have more room to line them up all like that, because I was told.
Well, we need Jan now. We need our...
I know, our silent producer.
Yeah. Where is she when you need her? Oh, she's working. Okay.
Yeah, whatever.
Yeah.
Excuses. All right, I do have one over here. Don't let me forget. I have Michael's that I set aside over there.
Yes.
All right. I'm getting there. Come on. This stuff is all buried. You should see my desk. Instagram a picture of that mess. Not. All right. Yeah.
Lynn's is enjoying something probably very, very much. I apparently slave cooked her a hamburger.
Whoa. He actually did that, like, on his own?
Apparently, hey, yeah.
I'd say keep him if I were you. All right, here we go. This is the mandala. I think this is all the mandala.
Oh, cool.
Beautiful. All right, there you go, T. Picture time.
Oh, this is cool. Jazzy's saying that she's mesmerized by the whole show. Oh, everything's so Jazzy. Gorgeous. That's nice.
I just got kicked out. The photographer, I wish I could take an Instagram picture right now. He's in my workstation and I'm standing back letting him
sing. Cool. Oh my gosh. Way to go, T-Dog.
I'm telling you, he says I couldn't get a good angle with you standing there. I think we're gonna chat later, but whatever. You know, if you're missing out on the live shows that we do in person, this is what you're missing out on, because you get to see us interacting quite well. That's what I'll say.
And the conversation is just amazing going on over there. It just runs the gamut, the whole show.
All right, not sure if you're seeing all these. Yeah, did you forget? I think you forgot. Look at this one. So there's that one, but then there's that one that you love so much. Yeah. And then saved for the new grandpa. We're going to do something special with these.
Aw, how nice.
That would be really cool. Wouldn't it be cool to do a Kraaft It Live? I don't know. I'm going to have to pass it by him first, okay? But I have an idea for something I want to make for his granddaughter. We'll see if he says it'll be okay once I tell him what it is. If he wants that done, if he wants that done on live is what I mean to say. So what do you think, guys?
Oh, it's excellent. Yay. Golf claps, golf claps. It was wonderful. It's been a great show, and the comments are just absolutely fantastic comments. And well, T-Dog's done a wonderful job. Wonderful.
Again, T-Dog, they're praising you. You did a great job. I'm repeating to him because he can't hear what's in my headphones, you guys. Just for those who are watching the recording going, why does she keep telling him? He's standing right there. Because I have a headset on, so he can't hear anything. It's a very one-sided conversation for him. But anyway, Kraaft It Live is a live crafting show we do every Tuesday except for next week. And we spend time together doing live stuff. We have mistakes. We have fun, most of all. And I'm just grateful that you were here. So I hope that you had a good time with the jelly plate. I know I sure did. Take a look at Instagram if you want to see any of these close-ups that Mr. Photographer has been doing.
Director T-Dog.
Director T-Dog, my bad.
That's right. And
and I wanted to also point out one more time the DecoArt stencils that I did use today. These stencils were a hit, don't you think?
Yes, very much so. Beautiful.
Look at all the yumminess that they leave on there. That's going to be texture on later on too, so. Mm-hmm. Very, very cool. Thank you very much for joining us. I hope that you had a good time. Please, please have a very crafty day.
Bye, everyone. Bye, everybody. Thank you.